Every week, The Daily Show with Trevor Noah brings you the news that really matters.
Debbie Wasserman Schultz forced to resign amid a massive email leak.
Another email scandal? The Democrats get up to more with emails than the Nigerian prince.
Now, you always have to be prepared to walk.
The fact that you can interchange a Donald Trump quote with a drunk bus driver should make Americans very afraid.
You always have to be prepared to walk.
Plus, don't miss our continuing coverage of Election 2016. The Daily Show with Trevor Noah, new tonight at 11.
You're listening to The Morning Answer. Find us on Facebook. Just search The Morning Answer and react with Brian Whitman, Ben Shapiro, and Alicia Krauss.
Monday on The Morning Answer, Brian Bann and Alicia. Jennifer Horn will be around at 7 o'clock with that. She's coming off the Trump train. She has a full pass on the Trump train. It's a 24-7. It's a full pass.
Yeah, and that's what I've heard.
It's like the Metro, but it's called the Trump train, and you get a card, and you just swipe it, and you're on the Trump train.
It's not really gold, but it sort of looks like gold.
Well, you know what?
It's very fancy.
It looks a little bit less shiny this morning, the Trump train pass, because Washington Post, ABC News poll, following along with some previous polls, now has Donald Trump down 8 points over Hillary Clinton. Let me give you this number specifically. 50% for Hillary, 42% for Mr. Trump.
So this is going well. So this is this is not the only poll that looks like this. I mean, obviously, there was a spate of polls last week.
Obviously, it's still early, we should say, in the election as well.
It's August 8th.
August 91 8th, days.
And everybody,
91 days left.
And everybody else is, and everybody is already sort of, the congressional candidates are starting to run against Hillary now. Republican congressional candidates are starting to assume that she's sort of going to win, and they're starting to think about running ads that say, you need to elect us to Senate, you need to elect us to the House to be a check on Hillary Clinton, which, by the way, to me is a stronger pitch, actually, than they might normally have. Because
it worked
the fact
for GOP people in 2012 when Mitt Romney wasn't doing too hot against Barack Obama. They made their congressional and Senate campaigns of them versus Barack Obama's agenda.
That's right. It worked in 2010, it worked in 2012, it worked in 2014. So for congressional candidates, it's actually not the world's worst pitch that Hillary is going to win, and so we're going to be a check on her.